From card sharks, trivia trap, match game, Hollywood Squares, family feud, and the newlywed game. It's the best of Bob during Bobtober here on Buzzer.
Coming up next, let's play.
You are splendid. Join us next time on Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn, Tally Ho.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
Hi there, I'm Bob Eubanks, and you're watching the Newlywed Game on Buzzer TV. Let's play.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game. And here are today's newlyweds. This couple celebrated their marriage 6 months ago, Christina and Brian Herndon. Our next couple did the I Do's 3 months ago, Rita and Tony Galavis. This couple tied the knot 4 months ago, Michelle and Steve Duffy. And our final couple exchanged rings 15 months ago, Rhonda and Kevin Haslett. And now, here's the star of the newlywed game, Bob Eubanks!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the newlywed game, and hello to our couples. Nice to have you all here. Hey, we're going to have some fun. I can tell that right now. Ladies, we're going to send you off to our soundproof room, if you would please. And gentlemen, around one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins a fabulous second honeymoon. So, the ladies are gone. Here's your first question. Gentlemen, if your wife's mind was to drift off during lovemaking, where will she say it's most likely to go? To the office, to the mall, to the refrigerator, or to someone else? Kevin.
Oh, that's easy. It's definitely to the mall.
Going to the mall.
That's where all the shopping is, man.
My wife
is a shopper.
Shopper.
She shops,
yes.
And she shops and she shops and
shops
when she's done,
she drops.
She shops some more.
Thank you. Tony.
Definitely the mall.
You think it's a mall, too?
She was born to shop. Born to shop.
Really?
Oh.
Did you know that before you married her?
Yes. Yes, definitely.
You still married her, though?
I love her.
Well, that's very nice. Brian.
Definitely the mall. That's the place to be if you want to be pleased by a present.
Is that right?
Exactly.
Is that what you have to do?
That's right.
Okay. Now, you're just during lovemaking now, Steve. Is it going to be to the office, the mall, the refrigerator, or someone else?
I'll definitely have to say the office. She's definitely a
to
workaholic.
To the office?
Yeah.
Workaholic?
Yeah, she's a workaholic. She works all the time. She always comes home with different stories. She's
all right.
A nurse.
Next question, gentlemen. Financially speaking, will your wife say you are worth more dead or alive? Financially speaking, Tony, are you worth more dead or alive?
I'm worth definitely alive. We have great times.
Alive. I know, but financially speaking.
Financially, alive.
You're better alive. Yeah. Okay. You're worth more. Brian?
Dead.
Lord, yeah.
Don't give her a gun.
I hear you, man.
Don't give
yeah.
her a gun.
They're just standing around waiting, aren't they?
Please don't give her a gun.
Yeah, Steve.
I definitely stay alive. You know, I got several years ahead of me, I'm hoping.
So. Worth more alive. Kevin?
Definitely alive. Definitely. I can't work overtime if I'm dead, and that's where she gets her shopping money.
So. Oh, I got you. Okay. Next question, gentlemen. How will your wife say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. They say married couples begin to look alike, and it's true. Her blank is looking more like mine every day, and my what is looking more like hers. Brian? What is it?
Her belly. Just
her
like,
belly, yeah.
Yeah, we're both. We just had babies.
And your blank is starting to look like hers. What is it?
Oh, it has to be different. It can't be.
Yeah, it has to be different.
It has my butt, because it's big, too.
Your butt. Okay. That's good. Steve, her blank is starting to look like yours.
I'll definitely say her legs.
Her legs are starting to look like yours?
Yeah, they're
hairy,
getting a little
huh?
thicker these days. No, just a little bigger.
Okay, and... your what is starting to look like hers?
I'm going to say my rear end's looking a little bigger these days.
So. Rear end. All right, fine. Kevin, her blank is looking like yours.
Oh, man, her butt's starting to look like mine.
And your?
My belly's starting to look like
belly.
Hers.
Belly, all right. Tony?
My stomach's looking like her butt.
Okay, your stomach is starting to look more like her stomach?
No.
You're making a very simple question a whole lot harder. Let's try it again here now. Her blank, her what, is looking more like yours?
Her butt.
Is looking like your butt, right?
Like my stomach.
Ah!
Her nickname is Big Butt.
I don't care what her nickname is. I'm just trying to get the damn question right.
Okay.
Tony, what does she have that is starting to look like the same thing on you?
Her butt.
It's starting to look like your butt.
Right.
Oh, thank you. Okay, now, what do you have that's starting to look like the same thing on her?
Her stomach.
Thank you very much. We'll be right back. We'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Love Family Feud? Love Plinko? Hate the Whammy? Now you can play your favorite Buzzer games anytime. Just go to BuzzerTV.com and then select play. Have fun and let's play.
Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins a great second honeymoon. So, ladies, we're glad you're back. Here's your first question. Hey, if your mind was to drift off during lovemaking, where would you say it's most likely to go? To the mall? To the office? To someone else? Or to the refrigerator? Michelle, your mind's going to drift off during lovemaking. Where's it going? To the mall, to the office, someone else, or the refrigerator?
The Office.
The Office.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Really?
Well, we do the same job.
Oh, I see.
I'm a nurse and he's a paramedic, so we spend a lot of time talking about work.
Okay, Steve said your mind would drift off to The Office. Okay, Christina.
It better be the mall.
The mall?
The mall.
He said your mind would be at the mall. You got it. That's it. What do you think, Rita?
The Office.
The Office. Your mind just goes to the office.
Always. I think about work all the time.
Do you really?
And we talk about work all the time.
Really?
Yes.
All right. He said your mind, if you know, it would go to a card for me, please, to the mall.
Oh. Why?
You're always shopping.
That is not true. I work 12
hours a day. You were born to shop.
How could I
be shopping?
He said
you shop all the time, and he knew it before he married you, but he married you anyway.
Because I'm spending my own money. That's why.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay. Didn't tell us all
I
that.
I spend his when I run out.
Rhonda, where would it be? Would it be to the mall, to the office, to someone else, or the refrigerator?
Oh, without a doubt, it's the mall.
You think?
Oh, yeah.
You do a lot of shopping?
Oh, yeah. I'm born to shop.
Are you
That's
really?
That's what I do best.
He said it would be the mall. Yeah. Next question, ladies. Tell me. Financially speaking, would you say your husband's worth more dead or alive? Financially speaking, Christina, is he worth more dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. That's great. He said he is definitely, no, dead. Dead.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, well, baby, I figured you wanted to collect the insurance policy.
No. And believe me, baby, she would, too. Oh, yeah. Rita, financially speaking, he worth more dead or alive?
Alive.
He's worth more alive?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
I don't think he has... If he dies, I don't think he has anything.
And neither will I.
I was going to say, he won't have a damn thing if he dies. No, you're right. Tony said, financially speaking, he's worth more alive. You got it. Rhonda.
Dead.
Dead?
Honey.
How you gonna get the money to shop if I'm dead?
Well, the insurance.
The insurance, pal. You better get a food taster at home, pal.
Something.
Michelle.
Well, I just made him take out an insurance policy at work.
Yeah.
I'm thinking ahead here.
Of course.
So he's definitely worth more dead.
Dead, yes. He said he definitely is worth more alive.
Well, I mean, you're better alive.
Look at what you used to go. Ladies, how would your husband complete this sentence? This is him talking. They say married couples begin to look alike, and it's true. Her blank is looking more like mine every day, and my what is looking more like hers. Rita, I'm going to start with you.
My stomach is starting to look like his.
Yes, and his what is starting to look like yours?
His butt is starting to look like mine.
Stomach and butt. If they get this one right, I'm walking off the stage. Stomach and butt. He predicted you would say it is butt and stomach, opposite. No, he had them backwards.
At least he's in the same area.
Yeah. Okay, Rhonda.
My stomach.
Starting to look like his stomach, and his what is starting to look like yours?
His boobs.
Butt and belly. Hey, what do you do for a
living? I was wondering who's going to sleep on the couch tonight. I thought it was going to be me. It's going to be her.
What do you do for a living, Kevin?
I work for a major airline. Somebody's
going to
fly away.
Do they know you're getting boobs? Michelle.
I'd say that...
Your what is starting to look like his?
My gut.
Your gut's starting to look like his gut. And his what is starting to look like yours?
Arms.
His arms?
Yeah, they're getting a little on the flabby side lately.
His arms?
Ooh.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay, Mr. Macho. No, legs and rear end, he said.
I shaved? What do you mean my legs and rear end?
My arms are getting flabby?
She shaves her legs. Why did you say that?
No, it's just they're getting a little bigger around the side. I got big thighs. So. Hey.
Ooh, good right hand. Remember, you're worth more dead, pal. Christina.
Sure.
Christina, Your what is looking more like his?
Well, I'd say my gut.
Your gut. And his what is looking like yours?
His hair.
His hair. You know, come to think of it, you're right. All right, he said, your belly's starting to look like his, but his butt's starting to look like yours. All right, we'll be right back with the wives, and we'll see how well they can predict what the husbands will say right after these messages. I'm Bob Eubanks, and you're watching Bobtober right here on Buzzer. Let's play. Hey, welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Now, ladies, your husbands are secluded off stage, and it's your turn to predict what they will say. Remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. Hey, before I ask this question, let me... Janice, would you come out here and join us, please? Let me get Janice out here, if I could, please. Hi, Janice.
Hi.
How are you today?
Very good.
Notice where I'm looking. Janice, ladies, if your husband was shipwrecked on a desert island with a sex-starved Janice, exactly how many days will you say he would be able to hold off Janice's advances? Rita, how many days?
Oh, God, I'll give him one.
One day, okay. Christina?
A week.
How many days is
seven
that?
7 days.
7 days, okay. Michelle?
I'm going to give him 1 day to forget about me, so I'm going to say two.
Oh, 2 days. Two days,
yeah.
All right. And Rhonda?
Well, he's very, very strong, so I'd have to say 2 days.
Oh, he's strong. 2 days. All right. Thank you, Janice, very much. Thank you very much. All right. Next question, ladies. When it comes to your bedroom, what will your husband say best describes his recent behavior? Is it hit and run, twist and shout, or duck and cover? Christina?
Twist and shout.
Twist and shout. Michelle?
Our schedules have been so crazy lately, I'd have to say hit and run.
Hit and run. Rhonda?
No, I'd have to say twist and shout.
Twist and shout.
Absolutely.
Rita, would it be hit and run, twist and shout, or duck and cover?
It would be hit and run.
Hit and run.
We've been working a lot lately.
All right. 25-point bonus question. Ladies, who will your husband say left the very last message on your answering machine? Who did that, Rhonda?
I'd have to say my girlfriend, Simone.
Simone did. Rita? Mm-hmm.
My sister, Renee.
Renee. Christina?
My mother,
Your
Rose.
Mom. First name?
Rose.
Rose. Michelle?
My good friend, Rick.
Rick. All right. Ladies, thank you very much. We'll be back with the husband to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages. The Newlywed Game. All of our couples have scored 5 points. And now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. These are the big ones. All right. I'll tell you what we're going to... Before we get started, I'd like to ask Janice to come out here. Janice, would you come out here, please? Where's Janice? Hey. Say hi, Janice.
Hi, Janice.
Yes.
Hello, wow.
Oh, don't... Wow. I just said say hi.
I did.
I know you did. Weirdo. Okay. Gentlemen, if you were shipwrecked on a desert island, watch me, okay?
Okay, I'll watch you.
If you were shipwrecked on a desert island with a...
Watching you, Bob?
With a sex-starved Janice.
Oh, God.
Exactly how many days would you be able to hold off Janice's advances? Well, Janice, I want you to meet Brian. Brian, say hi, Janice.
Hi, Janice.
How many days are you going to be able to hold off her advances, Brian?
Forever.
You're going to be able to hold them off forever.
Yeah, definitely. I love my wife. I may be, you know, playing, but no way.
Your wife really knows you, too. That's what's so interesting about this. She knows you, yeah. She said you'd be able to hold them off 7 days.
What's wrong with you? 7 days?
Well, honey,
how could I want anybody but you, darling?
Oh, honey,
forget
love.
It. I'll be a mom.
All right, let's go to the old guy. Hey, Tony. Tony. Be like barbecuing a steak
mouth?
With a pilot light, Tony. How many days, Tony?
1 day.
1 day, she said. 1 day! Yeah. Boy, Kevin has been over there, has not said a word, you guys. Yes, Kevin, how many days?
Bob, I have a will of iron.
Yes, sir. How many days?
Forever.
Forever. All right. She said, you have a will of iron. It would be 2 days.
2 days? 2 days? She
too
skinny for me, baby.
Well, I mean, look at her. I'd go for that.
Look at old Steve. He's starting to sweat. How many days, Steve?
This is a rough one.
No, it's not a tough one.
I'm going to say 7 days.
7 days.
Seven
yeah,
days.
Your wife
about
said,
a week.
She said 2 days. Just 2 days.
What?
Yeah.
We'll
Janice, thank
than
you
that.
Very much. Thank you. All right. Say goodbye, Janice.
Okay.
Next question. Gentlemen, when it comes to your bedroom, what would you say best describes your recent behavior? Would that be hit and run, duck and cover, or twist and shout? Tony, which one describes your behavior?
Twist and shout.
Twist
definitely.
And shout. Way to go, Tony. She said
good
hit
thing
and
you
run.
Got the last one right.
Hit and run.
Hit and run. Yeah.
Well, we've been working.
Oh, that's
think
right.
about
yeah.
it.
Kevin.
Say the three again.
Yeah, would it be hit and run, duck and cover, twist and shout?
Twist and shout.
Twist and shout. She said twist and shout. Yeah. Steve.
Oh, this one's easy. We're so busy right now, it's got to be hit and run.
Hit and run. She said hit and run. All right, Brian.
I'm going to go for the hit and run shout.
Hit and run. She said for sure it's twist and shout, Brian.
Oh.
Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer.
You're going to Antigua. You'll stay at the famous St. James Club in Antigua, an idyllic all-inclusive resort, boasting beaches, water sports, tennis, entertainment, and more. The St. James Club, Antigua. Have a fabulous second honeymoon. There you go, Bob.
All right, John, thank you very much. Here it is, our 25-point bonus question. Gentlemen, for 25 points, who would you say left the very last message on your answering machine? Let's go first to couple number two, Brian and Christina with 5, 25. Would give you 30. Get it right, you'll be in first place, Brian.
Nikki.
Nikki. All right. She predicted you would say it was her mother, Rose. Couple number one, Steve and Michelle with 15, 25. I give you 40. Steve, take over the lead with the right answer.
That would be Rick.
Rick. She said Rick. That's right. Okay. Couple number three, Tony and Rita with 15, 25. I give you 40. Tony.
Vivian.
Vivian. She said it was.
Oh, my sister, Renee.
No, Renee. Couple number four, Kevin and Rhonda. You have 15, 25. I give you 40. Get it right and you're tied for the lead.
My mother, Drusilla.
Priscilla? She said, no, it was Simone. That means a couple number one, Steve and Michelle. You're Newlywed Game grand prize winners. Well, thanks to all of our couples, and most of all, thanks to you at home. I'm Bob Eubanks. Say, hey, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye. more Newlywed.